Have you ever thought about doing 360-degree food photography? If not, let's learn how to do it. My name is Ibrahim. I'm a food and product photographer from Spinteraz Media. I'm also going to give you 3 hacks, which is going to make your life much easier while shooting it. Let's begin. Okay, let's get this clear. There's a major difference between food photography and product photography while doing 360. Most of your product will never change its shape or color while you're shooting it. Okay, all the sides of the product always remain same also. But food ain't like that. So you have to be very fast and adaptive to the kind of food you're shooting. With that clear, let's see what all you need to shoot. The first and the foremost thing you would need is turning table, measuring tape, and a pointer. I'm not digging deep how to make one. There is this amazing YouTuber who have explained it all in his video. I will put the link in the description. The second thing you would need is 3 lights. You can work your way with 2 lights, but I would suggest 3 lights. I will explain later in the video why. The third thing you would need is a softbox to give light all around your food and evenly lit food. Okay. The fourth thing is either remote or tether capture. You can work with Canon, Nikon, Lightroom or Capture One. I'm shooting with Capture One. The fifth thing you would need is a steady tripod and a camera, obviously. With all that acquired, let's get on the set. So I am shooting everything on my Nikon D810 with an 85mm lens. Okay, you can choose your own focal length. I like to go closer to the subject, so that is what I'm doing it. I'm triggering everything from my flash, okay? And let's set the light first. So the first light you would need is your fill light, okay? It is going to be the most powerful and also going to be a little bit on the topish side for it to give an all around fill light. And you also want to remove the background. So in the softbox, you want to put your light in such a way that it almost removes the background. It gives you a clear white background and a fill from the back. Okay, so you can check it here. Now, the second light is going to be your kicker light. Okay, it's going to be a little bit less than your main light. Okay, it's going to be opposite, not bang opposite, but it's going to be a little bit opposite side of your first light. Okay, and the third and final light is going to be your face light. It's going to take away all the shadows, okay, which is being created by both the lights. So if you take 2 lights, if you just shoot with 2 lights, it flattens the food very much. Okay, so putting third light, so first light in the background, the second light at the kicker position, and the front light, okay, the face light, is giving a little bit hint. It gives away a little bit shadow. That way your food will get its character and also the front shadow will give it a beautiful shape. So that is how I shoot it. You can choose your own style, but I would say 3 light will do the job. My camera setting will be, shutter will be 200. I'm going to keep my ISO to minimum, that is 64 ISO. And my aperture is going to be 11. Okay, it's time for our first hack. Okay, when you're doing food photography in 360, you will always want to make sure that you're not shooting white plate or shiny plates or bowl for that matter. Why? Because you have to remove the background in post because you want it to be seamless. So you always want to spray paint with either matte or some kind of color or always use crockery which is not completely blank in one color or no solid color for that matter. That way it'll be way easier in post to remove the background or work with it. The in general rule of 360 is the lesser the distance between two images, the smoother it's going to look. So let's say if you're shooting after 2 inches, a picture after 2 inches, okay, is going to look a little bit jerky. 1 inch will make it a little bit more smoother, and 1/2 inch is going to make it a video-like. So you have to choose your own style, how you want. You want it, the movement to be really smooth, or you want it to be a little bit jerky. It's time to get some food on. It's time to shoot. It's time for the second act, which is to organize your images. See, we were shooting 20 dishes and each dish have 120 images. That's a lot of images coming in. We were in such a mess, but what we finally did is change the root folder after shooting each dish. That way we had 20 folders, but each folder have all the images, and post-processing them separately was much easier. You can do that easily by going to your software, whatever, whether you're using Canon, Nikon, Capture One or Lightroom. We were using, as I said, Capture One. Okay, just go to the directory and change the root folder. And that way the post-processing, okay, is much easier.
Oh, thank you, you're here.
So the third and last hack is from our food stylist, Swati Desai.
Hey guys, Hi, I'm Swati and I'm a food stylist and a tabletop director. So up until now I've done a lot many food styling assignments, but this one is a unique one and I'll tell you why. Because we're doing it for AI and artificial intelligence needs to see food all around. So the camera is going to see all my tricks and I cannot use none. So, I'm going to give you 3 tips, how do you do that? So, when the camera is going to see this way, why don't you put your food on a turntable and style it? That's my first tip. Second, when you choose, you have to choose your front side so that the camera can know this is your front, back, sides. Because just as a person has a front face, your food also needs to have a front face. And maybe the third tip could be, if you choose a circular plate or a circular bowl, it will really help define the food, and when it moves in an AI app, it looks better. Maybe squares and ovals have their typical edges which don't really look nice. So hopefully you have a better time styling something like this. Enjoy styling. Thank you.
Alright guys, before I leave you with the final result, if this video was any help to you, don't forget to smash the like button, subscribe and hit the bell icon for upcoming videos. And if you really like our content, you can always support us on patreon.com. I will put all the link in the description. If you have any query or questions to ask, you can always put them into the comment box. I'll see you in the next one. Enjoy.